All right, welcome back to the Jimmy T podcast, and we're kind of here to talk about today what is a big question over the college football college athletic landscape as to whether or not athletes should receive compensation for their work here at universities such like the University of Central Florida. And it's something that a lot of people have very different opinions on, and it's something that we just kind of chat about today. So I'll kind of let you kind of go first. What would be your first point as to thinking about this and kind of explain that?
One of the things I think is when you think about college athletics as a whole, what do athletes that come in with full rides already get? And that's things such as they get their own meal plan paid for, they get their own tuition paid for, they get books paid for. So basically everything you need to succeed in school-wise is already paid for.
So then your thought process on them being paid is...
No. I don't think that should happen because everything's already paid for. If they want to take the money that's being paid for everything already and take it, we'll pay them that money and leave everything else unpaid. That's how I feel like it should go. So if you want the money, then... We won't pay for tuition.
Yeah, exactly.
We won't pay for food or anything.
Exactly.
And you can eat out wherever you want to, but this is the lump sum you get. So if they want to take it like that, then I can agree with that. But other than that, they shouldn't get paid extra on top of what they're already getting.
Yes, I agree, as unpopular as it may be, to definitely a lot of college athletes is kind of in the realm of like kind of saying that programs like this for UCF, they say that There's a lot of people out there, and like a Jay Billis, and a lot of these other people that are at the forefront fighting for payment and compensation for college athletes, is that saying that the NCAA and these universities, athletic programs specifically, are making so much money off the backs of these students, when that's not the case. It's not. Where at an NCAA level, there could be maybe a little bit more of a discussion as to whether or not this would be the case. But you need to actually look at how the NCAA set up and how all of this stuff works, and it'd be a very different discussion. But from a straight standpoint of looking at the UCF athletics program, because as we are a UCF show, so it's easier to look at it that way, is to see that, think of all the college athletics programs that are out there in the United States that are all under the branch of the NCAA, all these athletics programs, on average, a little over 20 of them each year actually make a profit, meaning that they actually make money to a certain extent. Guess what? UCF is not one of them, and a lot of schools aren't. That not every school, and I don't exactly know which schools these are. This could be like an Alabama. A lot of ones that have a lot of booster-driven stuff behind them, like a Florida State as well.
Yeah.
They have a lot of boosters and alumni that provide a lot of money, and a lot of students go to the game and pay to go to the game. That these programs where they do make money, the argument could be like, well, why don't they pay those players? Is that it could cause an issue for schools like UCF. Because how are we going to convince anyone going to want to come here?
Yeah, if they're not getting paid.
Yeah, they're not going to get paid. So it's going to create what could be a monopoly in college football, a player monopoly, of like just a very broad, simple sense that like North State University is able to pay these players while South State University isn't. So all the players are going to go to North State. And it's looking like, why? Why? It's not because that's a big issue. And it just looks at it from that standpoint, it kind of is like, it's a big no. Then do you have any other kind of points to kind of break down that it's just not a big no?
Yeah.
It's just that there is a lot of stuff behind this that doesn't make us an easy answer.
No, there is a lot of stuff, including that when you become a college athlete, there's a lot in your schedule.
Yep.
So you have to go to practice 2 times a day, go to study hall, go to eat at a certain time, go to training sessions, go to rehab. So, I mean, they have a demanding schedule, but demanding schedules don't just come from athletics. Demanding schedules could be someone in a biology degree. They have multiple science classes. They have to study for the same hours that you're at practice, they're out there studying to get their degree. So, I mean, demanding schedules is to each his own, basically. But I understand the fact that if you have a crazy degree like chemistry or something like that and you're trying to play sports, then that's a demanding schedule there. So that's just a balance that some people have to find. I don't feel like you should get paid to do that, because at the end of the day, people that do it all the time, people have passed by and done it already, and they've made it without being paid to do it. So for years, college sports on a whole has gone on without payment, and players just wait their time to get to the NFL. So or NBA, whatever it is. So I feel like that's the same thing that should happen.
And for many, to kind of piggyback off that point, that this is a job in a sense. That this is helping you go to school. That it is for either to a certain amount, to full ride, anything along those lines, that it is a job. That you're here to do this, and that's why you're able to be able to pay for school. Is that this is being all paid for you because you're performing at this job. And then to kind of look at it from the standpoint that, I know Leland and I talked pretty in depth about this over the weekend, kind of back and forth, was that like, well, what about the ones that don't go to the NFL, that don't go pro? And that's, you got to look at it as like, they need to understand that this is their way they're going to be able to get through school.
Yeah.
So they need to be able to set themselves up. And that kind of goes to my next point of that, it's kind of looking that, well, if not payment, because a lot of people, payment, that it's not a possibility.
Yeah.
Because programs like UCF, they won't tell you this, but 60% on average of their revenue that they make is from student tuition fees. Like, and that's why UCF students are able to go to all the college athletic games for free. Is because of this, because it's kind of looked at from the point is that you're already paying to help support this athletics program through your tuition fees, that you should be able to do that. So that means the athletics program is pooling however much money per credit hour or however how much they want to do that. They're getting it from 60,000 plus students each year, but that is the majority of their revenue.
Yeah.
So that's a little concerning, that it's essentially, there's no such thing as free money, but from their standpoint is that they're not really having to do anything to earn that money, and that's already majority of the revenue they make. And so it's kind of look at expenses and all of that, that it's like, there's no way. It's not there. And if they want to do that, show me the money. But I think the better way to do this, to kind of go back to the point I started with the NCAA, is that there needs to be more focus on these college athletes, student athletes being students.
Yeah.
And that needs to be what they're pushing and enforcing as the NCAA, because there's a lot of inconsistencies as to how all of this is being enforced. That they're kind of rewarding programs, as we've seen scandals in the past, most notably North Carolina, that a lot of students, players, athletes, it was more of a focus of the football team because football is king on college campuses because of money. That's not an insult to other sports. Look it up. You see where majority of the money keeping your programs going is coming from the football program, but that's besides the point. Is that you need to be able to say that, no, this player can't take what was called an essay class, which was basically they just didn't have to show up and they just had to turn in a paper at the end of the semester and they would all get A's. That they need to not have those players take those classes, but to actually have them take major classes so they're doing that. That look at this from a standpoint on your resume, that you may not necessarily have a chance to get internships, but from the looking at that, you're going to say, I have this degree, chemistry, whatever, radio, TV, but look, I played 4 years at UCF. I played 4 years at Alabama. I played 4 years at Florida State. That's going to put
you... 4 years at Ohio State.
Yeah, anywhere. Any of these schools, any college athletics program that you played 4 years for, and then you're now turning your full degree that you got, and you're able to turn this into a profession outside of playing college athletics because pro sports. Because at the end of the day, college athletics, sports as a whole, those kind of careers are very not long-lasting.
Yeah.
I think the average career for an NFL player is like maybe 2 seasons.
Yeah, the NFL stands for not for long.
Yeah, not for long, and that's with any sport, that they need to help these students, help these athletes be better students, and to kind of, that's where the reform needs to be. Not in paying these athletes, but to make sure they get a quality education that they're coming here for, and that's how they won't be taken advantage of.
Yeah.
Is if they're helping them get a degree for the future, to help them better themselves. So this first round draft pick for the NFL does go out, play 5 games, destroy his knee, Teddy Bridgewater's knee, and then not be able to do anything about it because he just kind of didn't do anything for 3 years and left.
Yeah.
But that they make sure that guy leaves with a degree.
That's what I'm saying. I feel like programs themselves should come back to where players had to do all 4 years.
Yep.
So that ensures a degree right there, but it doesn't ensure people leaving.
No, exactly.
Before they get a degree. So in order, And maybe something even the NFL can, or NBA, NFL can step it up, that in order to get here, you have to come with a degree to get in the NFL.
That would be something that would be a big change. And I think it would be not a popular change.
No.
Because a lot of people look at this from the standpoint is that they're not coming here to get a degree. And for a lot of players, that can be true. I won't say that's fully true, because there are a lot of athletes that are coming to college. They want to be able to get a degree. That this is something that this was this player's chance to be able to get into a Stanford, a school like that, like a Syracuse, where it's like these like high walls, high barriers to be able to get in. But because I'm a good athlete with good grades, I'm able to get into these schools, a Georgia Tech, something like that. That we see this as, we're now able to get into this school, and I'm able to get a degree from an amazing university because of my athletics, that these players take it, not to say other players don't take it seriously. It's a hard argument because there's a lot of feelings on all these sides. But I think the best way would be reform in a sense of making academics a bigger priority over athletics. But that would be a monumental change that a lot of these people pushing for compensation do have a realistic argument in, is that the NCAA itself is more profit-driven than grade-driven.
Yeah, that's most definitely. But when you look at it again about paying them, you have to think, okay, we have students, let's say at UCF, they're going to be on to be dentists or doctors and save lives. They pay all their money, and let's say they pull loans. Eventually, they're going to have to pay all that money back. On top of that, they're saving the lives. So you come with your knee killed, your Teddy Bridgewater knee, they're the ones repairing it. So they didn't get paid to go to school to do that. They actually paid to do that to help you. And so, I mean, it's all a big scandal if you ask me. It's crazy.
It's a lot of it's very differing opinions. And from a basic kind of, I don't know, from a standpoint is that both sides are right. In a sense, to certain degrees, they're both right. But I think, as for the simple answer as to whether or not college athletes should be paid, it's no. From a more extended answer is that there needs to be different ways that this comes in. And I think that's something that is a better conversation to have, is to say, not about how athletes are being taken advantage of, the saying that they need to be paid as a compensation, but to kind of say from a standpoint as to, while they're here, are they, make it worthwhile, make it they're not being taken advantage of, make them be able to have a successful 4 years or however long they're at a university. Yeah. And this was a topic that, as you can see, I was definitely passionate about, and just both of us were, is because it's not an easy answer, and it's something that a lot of topics like this we will continue to break down and talk about, as they are relevant to the landscape of what we are covering every week. And it's something that you can also, will be underlying themes and all that in our episodes on Tuesdays that you definitely need to look for and check out. And this has been another episode of the Jimmy T Podcast, and we'll see you next time.
Charge on.